How's it going, everyone? I am Goran. Yes! Love that song. Who are you?
I'm Honan.
That's right.
Today.
Today is Honan. No, sorry, go ahead. What were you going to say?
Today, we are doing Minx double feature today.
Yes.
And in case you don't know, because I was throwing a lot of facts.
Oh, facts.
From a lot of facts. Not just Kpop dictionaries.
Facts.
Yeah. This was like before DREAMCATCHER.
Yes, I do know that. I do have some fundamental understanding.
Minus two members.
Okay.
Okay.
Gotcha.
And I guess this song, actually, the first one we're going to check out, Love Shake, is a Dal Shabet cover, which is their senior group on like their label.
Okay.
We've never really checked out too much.
No, to be honest, I don't. Maybe you have online, but that name didn't even sound familiar to me.
DREAMCATCHER things, but we've like barely checked out Dal Shabet. But yeah, that's pretty much like all the facts I know.
Oh, okay. Well, you just made it sound so... your extensive knowledge. I'm just kidding. So what are we watching first? This is Love Shake?
Yeah, Love Shake. And then the other one has a very long title. The other one is... oh, very... never mind. It's not very long. Why did you come to my home?
Why'd you come to my house, dude? Why'd you come to my home?
So I figure we'll... it's kind of interesting because DREAMCATCHER is like... one of my favorites, definitely top five.
Oh yeah,
probably top three.
Yeah, I think we've done more reactions to any group of Kpop than DREAMCATCHER.
And I feel like it's pretty interesting to know that they were totally different before they were DREAMCATCHER, because I can already tell just looking at this image right here.
Yeah, this is totally not within the DREAMCATCHER universe. So. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, but it is, but it's not, but it is.
Here we go.
All right,
Love
let's
Shake.
Do it. Oh, that's cool.
Who is this?
Oh my gosh, this is great. It's like knowing Trent Reznor did, you know, like 80s pop. So cutesy.
As Yuki said earlier in Queendom during AOA, they were doing the cutesy sexy.
Yeah, cutesy sexy. Which I don't understand how that works, but it does. Cutesy sexy.
It's so. Oh, dude, this. Dami, right? The rapper from DREAMCATCHER.
Mm-hmm.
It is so weird to see that.
I know. Hey, Ducks! I'm watching Minx! Can you believe that?
This is so weird. Like, there is my head still like bobbing for some reason.
I know. Yeah. No, it's still catchy for sure.
Dude, there's a lot of zoom ins
I know.
On them wearing
on their shorts and their legs. I was just gonna say.
This is so strange.
I think I enjoy it so much more
because their style and DREAMCATCHER, like what they wear and what they do to their hair and everything, is so different.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, it was a completely different time and group and look and everything. It still makes me kind of. This is gonna be stuck in my head. Hey Honan, you wanna shake it, love? How about a smoothie?
Not really sure what to say.
I mean,
the weirdest part about it is seeing members you recognize what they do in Dreamcatcher.
And then, like, Dreamcatcher, you, yeah, and I, like, is recommended
seeing,
next.
Seeing the certain members that you, like, recognize what they do in Dreamcatcher, especially, like, Dami, who does, like, the epic, like, rap.
Yeah.
Parts, you know, yeah, like, and just, I don't know.
I think it's really cool. Like I said at the beginning of the video, it's like knowing what you know about Trent Reznor's past from the 80s,
yeah,
and then thinking of like the iconic dark music. I mean, not that Dreamcatcher music is dark, it's just completely different spectrum.
I think some of it is
pretty dark, which is cool.
Dark
is cool. Metal, bro. No, I'm just kidding.
Yeah, it was so much more like of a sexualized concept,
yeah,
with like a very cutesy bubble pop.
Well, at least for that video,
bubble pop. No, just, like very much that vibe,
yeah,
kind of like going on. I don't know. I'm so glad that they rebranded. I really like the rebrand that happened.
I mean, Dreamcatcher, we already said it. Dreamcatcher is by far one of our favorite groups. If you guys know our channel or watch our channel, I mean, as soon as they were recommended, we love watching what Dreamcatcher has. I think just as musicians and their concept and everything is awesome. So, yeah. I mean,
it's an incredible switch.
Everybody starts somewhere.
It's an incredible switch.
I wish I had a music video that shows the music he used to make. No, I'm just kidding.
I don't wish that exists. That doesn't exist on purpose. I burned those tapes.
Still a good song. Still a good song. Google Gus MacArthur, Good Evening. I'm sure you've seen it. Look at his mustache.
Don't.
Okay.
Don't Google.
Look at his mustache.
it's just, I'm trying to imagine, like, the fucking meeting room where the guy who, or,
I gotta quack
or
every
woman,
time you say the F word.
Whoever was the person who was the rebrander, like, idea of that, they deserve, like, a raise. Like, to be in charge of the company. I don't know, like, because it was like...
We'll have to find out more about, like, how the whole rebranding started. Like, was it the group decided, like,
well, it was
because,
like,
hey,
like,
Oliver
was saying,
wanna...
like, it wasn't being very successful. Yeah. The, like, Minx concept wasn't doing very well.
Yeah.
And they just were like, okay, they added two more members. They rebranded the whole
thing
up. And did Dreamcatcher. That was just like, fuck yeah. There's another quack for you. There's another quack to... But I feel like, that was awesome rebrand. That's the greatest rebrand. I said it
in
Discord before. That's the greatest rebrand I've ever
seen. We just watched the one song, so let's check out why did you come to my home? Why did you come to my home? Okay, I'm just going to start it.
I can't lie, though. That song was catchy. I'm
thinking
about it.
It's totally stuck in it. Shake it. It's almost like a... I don't know. Reminded me of like a Brady Bunch song.
Yeah,
stuck
very
in.
Much so.
Yeah. A lot of zoom-ins on the shorts going on. Who directed these music videos? But a lot more EDM influence in this one than the... It's like steady EDM beat. Yeah.
So this is the only one that's like actually their song, because Love Shake was Dalshik.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. Yeah. So it
so
was,
that
it
song
was
kind of
a,
kind of a good, probably song from Dalshik, that style that they do. Like,
giant shoebox out there. This is a cool video.
Yeah,
like, I
like
loved, like,
it wasn't done bad. Like, the concept to me wasn't done bad.
I could easily see them being famous as Minx.
Yes. But I'm so glad that it became DREAMCATCHER.
Yeah, DREAMCATCHER is by far one of my favorite K-pop groups.
There we go.
This song's sick.
There's some rap.
Yeah. I'm actually surprised after seeing this video that they didn't have more of a following. I mean, they have all the elements it takes to create a good, I mean, a great group, so.
Probably at the time this came out, there was a lot of, I think it was like Sistar,
yeah.
EXID, and a lot of really already super successful.
Ooh! Dang! What does this remind me of?
Hold on, I gotta go back.
Hold on. Let the video finish. No, it's too late. Go ahead. Go ahead.
It finished.
What are you going back to?
That note.
Ooh! Damn.
See, like, all the talent was there already. Like, you knew it was, like...
Well, and that's kind of what I'm saying. Like, all the elements were there as Minx to clearly be famous. So, but I am glad they rebranded, because then we wouldn't have DREAMCATCHER. So, I mean, obviously, I'm much happier with DREAMCATCHER than I
think
Minx.
A lot of it not being successful in this concept had to do with the other groups
out at
dominating
the time.
This concept at the time.
Okay.
Probably.
And you guys will let it probably maybe.
Maybe
probably, but for sure. No, you guys let us know. I'm really glad we finally got to check out Minx. You guys have told us. I mean, we've checked out so much DREAMCATCHER. Everyone's always said you gotta go kind of see where their past comes from. And it's always good to see where people started and have, you know, developed and changed, because even we're getting like recommended DREAMCATCHER videos right after this, and just seeing like the covers and the look and feel, you can clearly see like they just went from 6 to midnight. Just like,
so the first one was that Dal was the Dal Schmidt song, and that was actually pretty catchy, like style.
Yeah.
This one had good elements in it. It's still just a little I don't know how to describe the song. Like, it's actually a pretty unusual song to me.
Yeah.
Like, the
I'm trying to,
maybe
the,
4 minute style.
There's
something
about that
for in it, like the
I'll comment in the Discord when I figure out what that reminds me of.
There's
something there. It's a song that I've heard recently. It reminds me of. It's so weird.
I'd already said it in the Discord. This is the like most incredible rebranding I've ever seen.
Yeah. No,
from
for sure.
This to DREAMCATCHER, because DREAMCATCHER seemed like such a already pre-thought out, like, very focused concept.
Mm-hmm.
And to think that it was like a thing that came from them not being like completely sure what to do with Minx, you know, to like that is a really insane switch.
Yeah.
And I'm just saying, whoever was in charge of that, you're the best.
Genius!
You're the best!
All right, guys. Well, thank you so much for the recommendation. Let us know. Well, you don't have to let us know, but let us know more information about the switch between Minx and DREAMCATCHER.
Yeah.
You don't need to let us know what to be watching, because we're always keeping our eyes out for new from DREAMCATCHER. But no, we're interested in some of the facts. So let us know below, and let us know what you thought of Minx when they were around, and maybe why they weren't as popular and had to switch to DREAMCATCHER. But as always, we really appreciate it, guys. And of course, if you are joining the Patreon, You are seeing new content first, and you're getting exclusive content as well. We just finished watching up some Queendom, but we do have another Queendom episode coming. I think it's episode 6, right? Mm-hmm. All right, guys. Well, make sure to subscribe, and we appreciate your support. I am Goran.
I'm Honan.
And we will see you next time.